This is one of the coolest 3D prints I've made so far. This is a lithophane, and it looks like a normal piece of white plastic in regular light, but when illuminated from behind, it reveals a detailed, vibrant picture. I printed this using basic PLA filament, and it works by varying the thickness at different parts of your image to control how much light passes through. So thinner areas are more translucent, letting more light shine through, while thicker areas are more opaque, creating shadows. And together, they form all the details of the image, like highlights and shading. Now, you might often see these printed in a single color or monochromatically, which works great for lamps or other light displays. But what I've created here is a multicolored lithophane where a thin layer of color is built directly into the print. This makes the image appear colorful when lit from behind, and it's like a glowing photo, but crafted entirely out of 3D printed layers. In this video, I'm going to show you that process of creating my first lithophane from start to finish, and how you can create your own as well. Hey everyone, it's Kevin, and if you've been following my channel, you'll know that I started 3D printing a few months ago. I got a Bambu Lab P1S, and it's been a lot of fun. I've created all kinds of things, from planters to practical items to pieces of art. There's just so much I've been able to do with it. So for my birthday last month, my sister Heather and brother-in-law Tom, who are amazing YouTubers by the way, I'll leave links to their channels below, gifted me a lithophane kit from Bambu Lab. This kit included everything I needed to create a multicolored lithophane, which was a backlight LED board and 4 spools of basic PLA filament in cyan, magenta, yellow, and white, or as Bambu Lab labels it, CMYK. If you're familiar with traditional printers, this is the same term used for ink colors, except in that context, K stands for key, referring to black ink. However, in this case, it isn't black, it is white filament, because lithophanes need a translucent material for light to pass through and create the image. So this was pretty exciting, because up until this point, I've only created standalone 3D printed stuff, but nothing like a lamp or anything that involved other components. And again, I was pretty intimidated at first, but it was super fun and easy to create. When thinking about what to design, I had been working on a series of decorative tarot-like cards inspired by video games. These cards were 3D printed using a technique called filament painting and software called Hue Forge. If you're curious about that process, you can check out my Zelda tarot card video, and I'll leave a link below. I was already in the process of creating another one for Halloween, so I decided to use that design as the basis for my first lithophane project. This particular card is inspired by the game Kingdom Hearts, which you might recognize if you're a fan of RPGs. This game was pretty huge for me as a kid. I was a huge fanboy of Disney and Final Fantasy, and to see them in one game was like a dream come true. Being able to see Cloud right next to Hercules was pretty mind-blowing for me. I really loved Kingdom Hearts because I loved the concept of going on an adventure, going to different worlds, but if I were to tell you what that story was about, I'm not sure I would do it justice, because I quite frankly don't remember exactly what it was about. The overall theme was about light versus dark. So you have your main protagonist, Sora, that has his 2 traveling companions, Donald and Goofy, and Sora is a Keyblade master that is in charge of protecting or sealing away the darkness, I think. And so there are different worlds in this, in Kingdom Hearts, inspired by Disney properties. So you have the Colosseum, you have Tarzan's jungle, you also have a Pirates of the Caribbean one, and in this case, you have one inspired by the Nightmare Before Christmas. I've always loved Halloween, and especially the Nightmare Before Christmas, because it's always just been so whimsical. And even when you think of Disneyland and the Haunted Mansion, here in Disneyland, California, they have an overlay of the Haunted Mansion to look like the Nightmare Before Christmas, and it's already my favorite attraction, but it becomes even more so my favorite attraction because I just love the aesthetic, the environment, the world, and the music of that property. Being able to see Sora in The Nightmare Before Christmas and see his attire, I've always loved that part in the game. So I wanted to create a tarot card inspired by that segment, and I know that's extremely specific, but I felt it was fitting for the season. In very broad terms, I wanted the design of the card to reflect what Sora looked like in that world. Now, to create this, I would generally take this into Procreate to do the early concepting and then take it into Illustrator to refine it and then take that into the slicer software or Hue Forge in order to create the filament painted card. But this time around, I decided to just use Procreate for the initial concepting and then use Blender instead for refining the entire piece. Now, Blender is a vector-based program, and since I've been working in it primarily for the past 3 years, I figure this could actually work since Grease Pencil is very similar to the pen tool in Illustrator. The only difference is that since Illustrator is a lot more Bezier-oriented, which is more relative to me, especially with this kind of work, it was a little bit hard to get used to, but as soon as I got my mindset into using the tools in the way I wanted it, it was totally fine. So I outlined the entire design with Grease Pencil using a thin black line. And to color this, I created 4 different color slots of varying values and then just added color accordingly. Since the first thing I wanted to create was the filament painted card, I learned throughout the process of creating the Zelda card and the Dragoon card, it's a lot easier to work with grayscale values in order to get the vibrant of the colors that you want. So that's how I first created the design, was coloring it in a grayscale value. So with the grayscale 2D version completed, I took it into Hue Forge to start filament painting. Now for the last 2 cards, I've been going with this pink and blue color scheme because I really liked it and I felt like it was fitting for this project. So I tried printing out this design using those filaments, which was a Sakura pink, a dark blue, a light blue, and a white. For the first attempt, I wasn't able to get the colors to look exactly how I wanted it, so I printed it again doing some adjustments, and this looked a lot better, except I didn't feel like even the color scheme itself represented the imagery, and I figure maybe I should go more with colors relative to Halloween, so maybe like a matte orange or a purple. And in addition to the Lithophane bundle, Heather and Tom did give me some other cool filaments I could experiment with, like a PLA sparkle and a purple silk PLA. So I figured maybe I should try that out. And I actually like this one a lot better, except there were too many details in the design. Over the past designs that I've made, I've been seeing how much of the fidelity would show through with my 3D printer. And I'm thinking if I had a smaller nozzle size, I could add a lot more. But since I only have a 0.4, I decided to pull it back and remove some of that. And then I ended up printing it again and adjusted some settings, heat settings, because I was getting a little bit stringy. And I definitely liked the design, how it looked the second time around, except I don't think the colors came out as nicely as that first orange and purple design that I made. So I didn't want to reprint it again. I was satisfied with the second orange and purple attempt, and overall, I liked how it turned out. Now, to create the Lithophane, this meant that I needed to color the grayscale 2D image that I made in Blender, which is pretty easy because I just went with the color scheme of the 3D printed tarot card that I made, but made the colors a little bit more vibrant. And that was pretty much just using the same purple, orange, light orange, and white that's seen in the card. This is pretty easy to do because, again, in Blender, you just designate 4 color slots and you can easily change those colors on the fly as needed, since each shape is assigned to that specific material. With the colored 2D version, I exported that again, and then I was ready to create the Lithophane. So for the Lithophane, there was a frame and a diffuser to accompany the backlight LED panel, which is this, and you can find that on their wiki on the website. I printed the frame first in this matte tan color, which took about 5 hours, and then I printed the diffuser in the basic Bambu Lab jade white color. And the great thing is that they provide all of the options you need to specify to make sure it prints accurately. To get ready for this print, I had to change all the filaments in my printer with the ones that came in the kit. So the cyan, magenta, yellow, and white. Then to convert my image into a Lithophane STL, I went to a website, lithophanemaker.com. Now this isn't something official from Bambu Lab, but it is a tool they support and is pretty big, as I understand, among Lithophane makers, so they have instructions on how to use it. Going to the website, specifically the Color Lithophane Maker page, you first upload your photo and choose crop. And if you're using the Bambu Lab Lithophane kit like I am, then you specify layer height to 0.15 millimeters, width to 144, and height to 108. If you want to shift the left or right spacing, you can, but I left it as is. For palette, they suggest to use the first one, Isun Warm White, but I actually use number 3, the True Blend, since I heard reports of over yellowing with some prints. Then you enter your email and you can download your STL files. Once you download, you're going to get multiple STL files, 5 for each color. In your slicer software, and I'm using Bambu Studio, you can go to File, Import, and then import all 5 of them as one object. Under filaments, bring in the CMY white filaments. Now, they recommend using a 0.2mm for this. I didn't have one and used a 0.4mm instead, and it came out okay. I'm probably going to try a 0.2mm the next time I create a Lithophane. Change the first layer height to 0.15mm to match what we set in Lithophane Maker. Then, under Strength, set the top shell layers to 3, thickness to 0, bottom shell layers to 3, sparse infill density to 100%, and infill pattern to rectilinear. Lastly, switch this tab to Process and assign the corresponding colors based on the file names. Then slice it. Now, it might look weird or crash, but it'll all work out in the end. Once you're done, you can print it out. Now, mine took only about 4 to 5 hours, but I imagine with a smaller nozzle, it might take closer to 8 to 10 with this size. I had a lot of fun with this project because it was the first time I designed something completely in Blender to fully 3D printing it. Anyway, if you are interested in getting one of my 3D printed cards, I'm planning on opening a store very soon with limited releases and other designs I've made. You can check it out now at kevinramp.com. Thank you so much for watching, I really appreciate it. And if you end up creating a 3D printed Lithophane, feel free to tag me. See you all in the next video.